Investing in rental properties for beginners, part three. I've already talked about house hacking and adding an ADU in part one. Part two, I talked about going outside of the Bay Area and Silicon Valley, but staying in California. And now I'm going to talk about taking that leap out of California to buy a rental property. So that's what we're talking about today. Stick around. I'm Annie Baker. I'm a realtor here in Silicon Valley. I specialize in selling homes in this area, but this is part three of my series on investing in rental properties for beginners. And here in part three, I am talking about leaving our state of California to get in the rental market. This is a totally different animal and there's a lot that goes into it. I am just going to talk a tiny bit, sort of an overview of things you should consider. I myself have investment properties out of state, so I'm a great resource of what not to do sometimes and what to do. So first off, are you looking really for appreciation and you just want to get most of your costs covered, but you're really interested in an area that's growing and you want to hold this property for a minimum 5 years and really enjoy the appreciation more than looking for passive income? Or maybe you really want some passive income. You want some extra income coming every month that is more important to you than the longer outlook of appreciation because you don't have a lot of money to invest. There are some great options for that. And hopefully you'll still see some appreciation over time. So first off, make sure you're very clear on your goal. And again, I think every real estate investor wants passive income and appreciation. That's the obvious. But depending on what your finances look like and what you can afford, it really will determine which is your main focus. There's no right or wrong answer. Everyone's situation is different. Number one, get clear on your objective. And number two, why wouldn't you start with somewhere you're more familiar? So if you've ever lived in another state, if you have family or friends that you visited, pick their brains about it. You might not be able to afford their neighborhood and where they are, but they might have a general idea of what's going on in their, you know, the greater area of where they live. Start there. If you really don't know anyone at all, I always say go to the real estate investment group in that community. There are meetup groups in a lot of these cities for investors. There's a website, biggerpockets.com, fabulous resource. There are a ton of people that invest out of their local area, wherever they are, and can be a great resource. Maybe they're investing in a certain area you're interested in. Get connected, plug in, start talking to people. My third tip is to talk to property managers wherever you're thinking of going, not just realtors. Property managers are the ones that are gonna be managing your tenants. They're gonna be finding new tenants for you. Talk to them. Where do they like to work? Where do they like to find tenants for? What areas are better than others? And pick their brain. And don't just talk to one. I would call at least two, if not three. Easy to find them online, and most of them are very willing to kind of help. It's a great start. Talk to people you know in other areas. Talk to property managers. Get connected on Bigger Pockets and meetup groups for investors. So don't hesitate to click on my link below to set up a time just to talk and brainstorm. I would love to help you in any way that I can. So until next time, have a great one.